Welcome to this session on deep diving into the secure and high-performing XProtect. My name is Mette Hjelm, and I'm Senior Product Manager for XProtect. And with me today to give insights on our security focus for XProtect, I have Carsten Bøgelund. Carsten, please introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Carsten Bøgelund, and I'm Head of Product Security at Milestone and Manager for the Milestone P-Search team.
Thanks, Carsten. And to cover another important topic for optimal VMS performance, my product management co-worker, David, will take you through great improvements to Milestone core competence on video handling. So let's start out to ask where to focus in 2021 when it comes to secure VMS. What is at stake? And see why cybersecurity is more important than ever, as cybercrime is the everyday threat to a safe and trustworthy world. According to Cybercrime Magazine and quoted by Forbes in December 2020, one of top five business focuses for 2021 is to cyberproof your data. Cybercrime Magazine predicts the global cost of cybercrime will be $6 trillion in 2021, which is the cost that equals to the world's third largest economy. The threats associated with cybercrime will not wait for a COVID-19 vaccine or more convenient times. The threats will still increase every second as part of the accelerated digital transformation. This is as well a reality in the surveillance and security industry, where we need to ensure reliable and trusted handling of IT system and data. At Milestone, we see big three big reasons why this will influencing all of us here today. First, we see extreme cost associated with cybersecurity all over the globe. Secondly, we see increased political attention and proposal for data governance regulations to ensure citizens' privacy protection. And thirdly, it is safe to say that all organizations will have to respond to this new reality. First, we see immense cost. The cost of a data breach is high. Average is $5.5 million in large enterprises. And the most expensive type of data breach is coming from malicious attack. Interviews made by Panamon Institute to identify causes to cybercrime show that malicious attack counter for 52% of all breaches. 54% of malicious attack were caused by three threat vectors. Compromised credential counts for 19%. Cloud misconfiguration as well count for 19%. And third-party software vulnerability counts for 16%. Another potential cost can occur as fines. The risk of non-compliance to local or regional regulation, for example, GDPR fines, aren't insignificant. There is a penalty of 4% of the global annual turnover or 20 million euros for non-compliance with the principles, which ever is the highest number. Fines are, as mentioned, becoming a serious risk. As seen here, GDPR regulation has come into a mature stage, and EU have by end of January 2021 fined 550 organizations with a total of more than 280 million euros and more to come. Political attention requires protection of individuals' personal data and thus ensure human privacy rights are fulfilled. Personal data footprint in the digitized world is everywhere. Personal data protection is being more and more regulated, trying to find the right balance between the benefits of the digitized world and the protection of the human rights. Example is the EU Commission striving for new set of rules for data governance to comply to. EU Commission is moving to next phase for data governance, as stated in press release November 2020. Here I quote, to better exploit the potential of ever-growing data in the trustworthy European framework, the Commission today proposed new rules on data governance, end quote, as a clear message for continuous follow-up to already existing governance, as, for example, GDPR. EU is not only one that has regulation on data governance to protect their citizens' right for privacy protection. Gartner is expecting half the world's population will have its personal information covered under local privacy regulations by 2022. To lower the risk for cybercrime costs and costs related to non-compliance to privacy regulation is putting pressure to all organizations. This means organizations' roles and responsibilities are changing rapidly. Milestone sees two trends that will have big influence to future market possibilities. The first trend we see is that investment in and deployment of IT systems and services is becoming a decision at top management level, often headed by IT department. This reality is also increasingly influencing the security and surveillance industry, as in customers' decision-making is a split between IT management and the managers and users of the VMS. The second trend we see is that IT ownership with increased influence and responsibility will set harder requirements to product security, both for the initial procurement and over the lifetime of the system. These two trends display an organizational transformation and grow in data and IT managers' influence and responsibilities, and result in an increasing focus to buying criteria and introduction of deployment governance. As part of our continuous research into this transformation, I recently had an interview with a security manager who had been working with VMS since introduction of CCTV systems in the 80s. He describes the support from an increasingly influencing IT team that now has responsibility for all IT systems used in the organization like this. The IT team set the criteria for VMS in regards to infrastructure, cybersecurity, and compliance. In fact, this is a great relief and helped the security manager, who now can stay focused on the process around the VMS and excel in securing people and goods. This is one example, and it is part of the organization transformation we see around the globe in varying levels in these years. We at Milestone are very much aware of the current cybersecurity threats, and we always look for the future threats to help us develop the most secure VMS solution. We work hard to ensure that our customers will be able to protect their important data and information and support them in meeting data governance regulations. And we will now tell you how we just do that. So please, Carsten, take it away.
Thank you very much, Mette, for this walkthrough of all the risks. So let me continue a bit about how it actually is that we are securing data in Milestone. In Milestone, our day-to-day business rely on the trust we have to the vendors that deliver software and services we use to conduct our business. We trust that these vendors will take care about and protect our data as if it was their own data. When our customers, you, are using our software and services, you show us that same trust. That we, Milestone, will protect your data with the same amount of carefulness. You demand secure products out of the box, so security should be a top priority that should be on top in the mind of everyone. This is where the Milestone Security Development Lifecycle, the SDL, comes in. Milestone have made the security development lifecycle mandatory for all software development since 2016. The SDL is a process with different phases that contain security activities that sits inside the classic people, process, technology triangle. The SDL forms the process portion. It includes both the central security team that governs the process and updates it, and the development teams that perform security activities. The technology portion consists of tools that assist in finding vulnerabilities in source code or discovering vulnerabilities in a running instance of the application. The SDL was developed during the time of Waterfall, so it is usually portrayed as a linear process that begins with requirements and ends with the release. In Milestone, we are developing software following agile principles. And when the SDL is extended to these principles, some security activities get integrated into the normal sprint schedule, while others are pursued out of band. In the requirements phase, best practices for security are integrated into the product. These practices may come from industry standards or be based on responses to problems that have occurred in the past. Requirements exist to define the functional security requirements implemented in the product and include all the activities of the SDL. The design phase of the SDL consists of activities that occur prior to writing code. Secure design is about quantifying an architecture and the searching for problems. An important activity during the design phase is threat modeling. Threat modeling is a process of thinking through how a feature will be attacked and the mitigation of future attacks in the design before writing code. Simply looking for bugs does not make software secure. The next phase is implementation or writing secure software. The SDL contains several things that programmers must do to their code so it has the best chance of being secure. This process involves a mixture of standard and automated tools. Formal test activities include security functional test plans, vulnerability scanning, and penetration testing. Vulnerability scanning uses industry standard tools to determine any system level vulnerabilities that exist within the product. Penetration testing, on the other hand, involves testers attempting to work around security protections in a given application and exploit them. Penetration testing stretches the product and exposes it to testing scenarios that automated tools cannot replicate. In Milestone, every release of our software is internally pen tested, and every other release is externally pen tested. The final phase, the release and response. A release can only occur when all security activities are confirmed against the final build and the software is made available for download. A successful release goes hand in hand with a hardening guide, a set of procedures which ensures a secure deployment at the customer side. Recently, the privacy guide has been added to ensure compliance with GDPR in the deployment. Another important part of a release is the response. In form of a product security incident response team, PCERT, that focuses on triaging and communicating product vulnerabilities, both individual bugs and those that will require industry-wide collaboration. Other security activities are also crucial for the success of Milestone security development lifecycle. These include a security champion program, continuous education and training, and other. The product incident response team, PCERT, is an entity within Milestone, which at its core focuses on identification, assessment, and disposition of the risk associated with security vulnerabilities within Milestone products and services. The Milestone PCERT manages the receipt, investigation, and public reporting of software vulnerabilities. The incident handling process at Milestone has four phases. First, there is the discovery phase, then we have the triage phase, and the remediation phase, and finally, the public disclosure. When a potential vulnerability is discovered, this can either be from an external source or as an internal report. The vulnerability handling process is triggered. This formal process for vulnerability handling ensures fast triage, prioritized remediation, and a coordinated public disclosure. So Let's take a look at how our approach to developing secure software turns into security features in the XProtect software. First, we have authentication, the process of verifying the identity of a person or a system. This is one of the most important security measures in a secure system. XProtect has for a long time provided a variety of choices to ensure the authentication experience can be tailored in a wide variety of deployments. In a Windows environment, the preferred choice has for many years been Kerberos. This allows an awesome single sign-on experience. An NTLM is still possible if you do not deploy in a domain environment. To further improve and secure the authentication experience, XProtect also offers two-factor authentication for member mobile clients. Also, 4Eyes authentication is supported. But if we're taking a looking ahead, the world of identity management is in motion. Having single sign-on in form of an Active Directory deployed on-premise is no longer as attractive as it used to be. The cloud has started to take shape, and we begin to see now that identities and identity management are moving away from our own server rooms towards the cloud. So Milestone has begun the journey to move XProtect towards embracing more identity providers, taking advantage of the cloud to make our single sign-on experience even better and ready for the future. With identities being the number one attack vector, an effective identity management solution is central to protection of data. When it comes to authorization, XProtect has always had a vast authorization model. It is based on role-based access with a lot of features to fine-tune access and provide the ability to follow the least privileges security principle, ensuring that users and systems only have the necessary access they need. Speaking of encryption, last year we did a major overhaul of the cryptography in XProtect. All cryptography throughout XProtect was reviewed and reworked to ensure compliance with the FIPS 140 NIST standard. Everywhere cryptography is used, whether it is at rest, in transit, or in use, the necessary changes were made to align with the requirements of FIPS 140. XProtect is now fully up to date throughout the product with the best cryptography algorithms and the newest libraries to ensure that XProtect takes care of your data in the best possible way. Media data, camera connections, tampering detection, credentials, sensitive configuration data, communication channels, and a whole lot more. This gives you the possibility to configure true end-to-end encryption and security. And we have made this even easier for you to configure through the XProtect server configurator. XProtect is the secure choice. This is where we are, and this is where we want to continue to be. In Milestone, we have over the years developed a security culture, both in the mindset and in the mode of operation. All the way from the visions and the ideas throughout recreating the requirements, doing implementation, testing the code, and the release and deployment. Milestone continues to improve and refine processes, educate people, evangelize security, promote transparency to continue building and maintaining the trust between Milestone, you, and XProtect. And now, let me hand over to David, who will talk about the awesome performance we have in XProtect. Thank you.
Hey, thank you, Carsten. So I'm David Kay, Milestone Product Manager, and I'm here with you today to speak about how Milestone focuses on efficient processing and delivery of video. The absolute core capability of a video management system is to be able to efficiently record, retrieve, and distribute video. With ever-increasing data volumes to process, driven by more cameras in typical installations, higher pixel density, and more clients, the requirements on efficient video processing keep increasing. We worked hard on this in 2020, and we will continue to do so going forward. Every XProtect release is thoroughly tested by our dedicated large-scale testing team to make sure that it meets or exceeds the video delivery performance of previous releases. We keep detailed statistics for every release to be able to measure the incremental performance evolution. We can, for example, see that over the last 2 years, the maximum count of cameras and recording servers that can be added to a single management server has increased by 30%. But it's not just about incremental improvements. I would like to speak about two areas where we recently have made real breakthroughs. Those are the mobile server and the smart client. So let's talk about mobile server scalability. So one interesting development that we have seen in the market is that more and more customers use a mobile client, XProtect Mobile. We also see many customers using the web client deployed in a web browser. Some of our customers have even started to use these clients as their primary interface to XProtect. For example, for a manager at a McDonald's restaurant, it is just so much easier to pick up the mobile phone and get an instant overview of what is going on in the parking lot, compared to the effort required to find a dedicated computer with a smart client installed. Much of the typical manager's interaction with XProtect is event-driven. That means that video is not the primary task. It is there to support when something has happened. And in those cases, the mobile phone is always nearby. And that is often more important than having the full feature set of the smart client. Another example is the many customers with users out in the field not having immediate access to a computer. We have police officers relying on the mobile client to know what they can expect to see when they arrive somewhere. We have park managers that need to check something on the spot. One of our customers runs a zoo. The animal keepers use XProtect, not for the purpose of security, but to check up on the animals so that they know that they're doing well. Naturally, offering a feature-rich mobile client with an intuitive and responsive user interface is key to serve these customers. But it's just as important to have excellent video delivery performance, to be able to simultaneously deliver video streams to a large number of clients connected through a single mobile server. I'm really happy that this is an area where Milestone has focused in 2020. We're proud to say that for an average installation, the XProtect mobile server can now simultaneously serve 10 times as many users as previously, measured on comparable hardware. So, how is this even possible? Well, there are two underlying technologies that have enabled this. These are direct streaming and adaptive streaming. Adaptive streaming means that cameras are configured for multiple parallel streams with different resolutions. The clients do not request streams with higher resolution than required to completely fill the current view item in the client that they're using. The other technology is direct streaming. Today, mobile phones and web browsers can decode and display high-resolution video encoded with H.264 and, in some cases, H.265. This means that the mobile server can forward these streams directly from the recording server to the client. No transcoding is necessary in the mobile server. So, by reducing the resolution using adaptive streaming and passing the streams straight through the mobile server without transcoding, and letting the clients handle the video decoding, we tenfold the number of streams that the mobile server can serve. All things equal, this also means that we can serve 10 times as many clients. An additional benefit from this is that there is now a smoother viewing experience with higher quality in the mobile and web client. We plan to continue to support and develop our solution for mobile clients in larger installations. And we look forward to be able to present new exciting features and improvements in this area in 2021. There's another trend in the market that I would like to speak about, and that is the increasing load overall. Camera pixel counts keep increasing, and it doesn't stop. Over a five-year period from 2019 till 2024, we expect the sales of 4K cameras to grow by an average of 34% annually. We know that pixel density is important for video analytics, among other purposes. More advanced video codecs, such as H.265, are used together with high-resolution cameras. This reduces the storage and bandwidth requirements. However, it also puts more load on the CPU and GPU, both for encoding and decoding. We also see that the number of cameras in a typical installation increases. More monitors with high resolutions are used in the control rooms, and customers want to view more cameras at the same time. Finally, software dewarping of video from fisheye cameras is now expected. Together, all these factors contribute to the computational load when the smart client renders and displays video. Distributing and rendering video is a core function of XProtect, and in 2020, Milestone R&D took a big step to redesign how video is decoded and rendered in the smart client. We can now safely say that XProtect utilizes the available hardware to 100%. For example, on a high-end machine with dual NVIDIA GPUs, we can now sustain 25 FPS while dewarping as many as 36 4K streams in parallel. Using our previous release, this was unthinkable. But it's not just about dewarping massive amounts of 4K streams. Customers will benefit from a more responsive and fluent experience when changing views. Smoother video with higher frame rates, less load on the hardware running the smart client, freeing up resources for other processes on that machine, and potentially lower hardware cost and total cost of ownership. This has been a great leap forward in terms of technology and performance. If your customer has performance problems in a smart client, consider to recommend them to upgrade to the latest 2020 R3 release. And this concludes my part of this presentation on security, privacy, and performance. Thank you for listening, and see you soon.